Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So today's video, we're gonna see the accessories which I bought after buying the Rock Rider ST520. So I thought of making a video more exciting by showing you guys a point of view kind of look. So I don't have an external mic with me right now. The audio will be a little bit muffled, so please bear with me. So as we go ahead, we'll talk about different kind of accessories which I bought along with the bike. I'll show you what are the most important things you should consider on the list. I'll put links all the products on the description if you want to buy it. So much easier for you guys to get them online or offline or whatever. Today weather is a bit good. Yesterday it was too much rain. The most important accessory you should buy is a helmet. I can see guys riding without a helmet. Maybe it's the instincts which have in me, because I'm a marine engineer and I work on board ship, which is always under hazardous condition. So it's a practice for us to assess the risk involved before doing any job. So it has actually become a second nature for me. So that's the first accessory you should buy, is always the safety helmet. Get any brand, but better get a decent one, because it's for your head, protection of your head. So you know, don't be conjuice on that. Just buy a decent helmet, so it will protect you whenever you fall in unfortunate incident. Accessory number two, the riding gloves. This will also protect you event of a fall. Unlike the other vehicles, especially car or bike, when we fall from bicycle, the first point of contact is always your head and the hand. Weight of the body always tends to go forward, and especially with the riding position always set in that way, most of the bikes, it's very easy to fall too forward. So you probably hit your head and you land by a hand on the ground. This will protect you from the fall, prevent you the skin peeling off from your hand and from a potential head injury. The third on the list is the clothes. It's always preferable to wear a cycling jersey. It's not mandatory that you should buy a cycling jersey in the first place, but if you are planning to get one, then that's the best option. You can also get cycling shorts which have a padded bottom, and it will make your ride comfortable when you're riding a long rides and all. But those shorts comes with a gel or a foam kind of padding inside, so the shape will be similar to your seat. It will give a more proper cushioning. You should get always a shorts preferably. It's not a good idea to ride with jeans or long pants or anything. Get yourself a shorts and a dry fit t-shirts. The next on my list is a pretty decent shoes. You should always ride with the shoes on. Avoid using shoes which have so much cushioning, because it will reduce your power for pedaling. So you should put more effort while riding. You can buy any shoes. You can buy a running shoe, or you can get cycling shoes if you want, which will clip on the pedal. Advisable for road bikes especially, and if you are riding in a, you know, good road conditions, especially in Indian roads, it's not safe to use that clamp or clip kind of shoes for cycling, in my opinion. Fifth one is the mask, which probably should have been first because of the situation of pandemic, but anyway. So preferably get a rider's mask. It's much easier for you to wear them when you ride. You get too sweaty, and the normal mask will, you know, get wet very soon. You can get it online or offline shops, get it for cheap price, but better invest in a good pair of masks. And when you buy clothes and masks, buy like few of them, minimum two or three pairs, so you can swap them without, you know, hassle of washing it every day. The next important stuff is your lights, especially your signal light. You should always get a battery powered tail light and a headlamp. This has a mobile holder, plus is a battery bank, and also has a horn. So if you want to get some attention of the people, you can have by pressing the horn. That's the horn. L is not so, you know, not so loud. People don't take you seriously. Always good to have a backup if your battery fails on this one. One thing you should be careful about this is the stray dogs. You know, don't provoke them. Just be on the safe side and move along. Dogs while cycling is a big hassle. Just ignore them. Don't look into their eyes. Please bear that in mind. In case if you're wondering, this place is Vaipin. It's a place located in Kerala, in the Ernakulam district of Kerala. One of the beautiful places here. They also have good tourist destinations. The Charai beach is here on the other end of the island. Basically, this place is an island. Even though I'm staying in Bangalore for a few years, this is my hometown. This is one end of Vaipin Island. This is the best end on the left side. We have a boat jetty and Jengar jetty on the other end. Now I'll show you my school. I always feel so nostalgic when I come to this place. You know, this is where I studied till 10th standard. The Lady of Hope Anglo-Indian High School. But right now, the high school has been moved from this place. This is where we used to play during the lunch breaks and all. Okay. But the whole island is called Vaipin as well. This is one of the oldest church we have there. Oh, by the way, this is our, you know, kindergarten. It's now pretty old. The building is closed now. Okay, I don't want to bore you with my stories, so I'll see you on a different location. So finally I reached home. My battery died. Let's continue with what we were discussing. Okay, I will show you one by one what all the accessories which I have fitted on the bike. Okay, this is a memory foam seat cover. So normal seat is not so comfortable, which I told on my last video. This is a memory foam which you need to get. This is actually having some cushioning inside, so this will give you a much comfortable ride. You have just slide it in and tighten this up. If you want, you can tie it back here. Okay, so I was talking about another important thing earlier, which was the lights. So this is the tail light. So you can get this from Decathlon. It's a Bitwin product. So this have a two button type battery. I don't know how long it will last. One mode like this and a constant mode. And you press one more time, it goes off. So it's off, SOS mode and constant mode. This will probably give you good visibility when you're riding, especially at night or in a rainy condition. So you can just notify the other drivers on the road that you are there. That's way, way more important than anything else on this bike. So that's a tail light, and you have the headlight, which I was talking about earlier. This I bought from Amazon. This is a product from Fastped. So this have a mobile phone holder. So you can keep the phone over here. Then you have this two light, and you have this wire coming out, and this is the horn. So you just need to press this. Also, you have a charging port given on this side. So this is for charging, and for charging a mobile device, you can connect a small cable from here and onto this hole, and you can charge it. And this is my GoPro adapter. So if you're a YouTuber like me, this will definitely become handy for you. And this is a bottle holder, and it's a water bottle. Okay, this bag is something which I liked. This is called a frame bag. The one more bag called a saddle bag, which you can keep underneath the seat. But this made more sense to me. The reason I bought this bag was the mobile pocket. Even though I have this mobile holder on the light, but if you are riding on rain, then there is no protection for the phone. This is not waterproof, but it's a little bit of weatherproof, I would say. They have provided kind of holes inside, if you can see. So any water going inside through the zipper will drain out through this hole. This opening for the mobile and two pockets here and here. Fixing is very simple. You have one securing on the front and one securing on the bottom.
and the bag is secured on the frame. If you're buying this, make sure you have a flat frame. Okay, so and what inside the bag is this? This is a multi-tool. You have all sort of Allen keys and screwdrivers which are necessary for opening of different parts on the bike. So this is a very handy tool. I would highly recommend to get one and keep it with you always. Okay, I carry this plastic bag just in case if it rains, I put inside my helmet in case of rain. So that's for that. I have this portable puncture kit. This on the bike, these are the accessory, and this one I shown on the last video, but if you're riding on the road, then it will be a good options to fix the stand. You can get this one also from Decathlon for this bike particularly. You can get a similar one from the Amazon as well. Alright, coming back to my bag, let's see what's in my bag. So this is my carrying bag. So basically I carry a few things in this. I have a rain jacket, so in case of heavy rain you can easily get home without getting wet, give you protection from rain maybe for one and a half hours max. After that the water start seeping inside. This have ventilations here and it doesn't have a hood, but it's zipper type, and you have ventilations over here as well. You have a small pocket over here in which you can put something. That's the raincoat. Then I have this portable pump which can be used in case of any emergency. So you just pull it out, connect it and unlock it and then pump. So that's how easy it is. This will go easily inside this bag. And I have one more, this is my GoPro mount, and I have one more repair kit just in case. And one good thing about this bag is that this is really portable, in the sense you just have to open the zipper and the whole bag comes into this pocket. This is of 10 liter from Decathlon, very convenient. So these much of things will fit inside this bag easily. So that's the bag, the pump, the repair kit and the raincoat. And this is the helmet which I use, the Van Rysel one. This is designed for road bikes, but it's good. This comes with a head strap, you know, the adjustable head strap and the chin strap as well. And you have easy good amount of ventilation through these holes. So yeah, so this one good of a helmet. I also have this lock which unfortunately I never use on my bike. So don't buy this. If you want to buy a smaller one. And this is the sunglass. But since I'm riding with a mask, it's very difficult to wear this because it will get fogged very easily. So yeah, once the pandemic is over and if you're riding without a mask, yeah, and you can consider this as well.
Those were the accessories which I bought along with the bike. So if you guys like the video, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it already. If you are guys interested in learning photography, I have started a new series in Malayalam. So any Malayalis out there, please do check out that video, and if you're interested, do subscribe to the channel and follow and press the bell notification so you get notified when I upload a new video. So that's it for today guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So until next time, it's me Sue signing off. See you guys on the next one. Peace.